Coming up on Rucker's Reno, family traditions shine bright as the dining room gets its moment in the spotlight, and I get to explore Charleston's unique food and farming culture. Hey y'all, I'm Darius Rucker and I invite you to join me on a very special project. I'm renovating my historical home in my favorite city in the world, Charleston, South Carolina. I take great pride in being your private guide through this bustling, vibrant city. While phases of construction are being completed, we'll be exploring Charleston and experiencing just a few of the amazing people, places, and things that make me truly love this city. Grab a seat or a hammer and come on into Rucker's Reno. Okay, this, we want to be the dining room. You know, I just think, because meals, like growing up in Charleston, Sunday meals were always so important, you know, great place for the family to eat. So this room, and I love this room. You know, growing up, we ate together, especially on Sunday. Sometimes with busy schedules and, you know, mom working as much as she did, we might have not gotten to sit down and have a family dinner, but Sunday was all about family and friends and sitting around and eating. And you know, the big dining room tables were always in the house. Even if you didn't have a lot of money, you had a big dining room table because you knew there was going to be a lot of people sitting around. And we had those friends that always seemed to stop by right at dinner time. You know, they just always seemed to, hey, what are you guys doing right at dinner time? But we loved it.
Yeah. Look at these floors.
Yeah, the floors are.
The floors are great. The floors were covered up when we bought the house, which was amazing to me because these are beautiful.
Wow. Yeah, they really are.
We'll have to do a little patching over here.
Over here?
Yeah.
Repair.
Yeah.
See up here.
The mantle is beautiful. Definitely.
Oh my God.
Keeping
the thing that gets me about the mantle is that was all hand done.
Yeah.
Look at the detail on that mantle. Yeah, we'll definitely have to pull some paint off that and restore. Look at the scene.
Yeah,
it looks like a hunting scene.
Yeah.
And a church and some trees. That's fantastic. All done by hand.
That's gorgeous.
In the 1800s, right?
Yep. Yeah. All done by hand by slaves.
Early 1800s, yeah.
And you know, the fireplace, I just think that could be the focal point of the room.
Yeah, absolutely. We could do a really beautiful marble surround, and to have that while dining is pretty amazing.
Yeah, and dining, those beautiful windows looking out on Broad Street.
Yep, right on Broad.
So this is gonna be the butler's pantry, whatever. This used to be the porch, you were saying, right?
Yeah, look at it. Look at this, we got a door. Windows.
I think we're going to have to really utilize this whole wall. This is the most wall space we have.
Yeah.
You know, so this can all be, we could detail this with millwork. So this will really be functional, but it could be really beautiful too.
Yeah. Utilitarian, beautiful room because we're passing through it.
Exactly.
It's going to be a circulation path.
I have some ideas.
I'm sure you do.
So for the architectural plan for the dining room, the challenges are really the mechanical heating and cooling. The space is gymnastics. We're gonna have to come up with something in this closet, I think, and we're just gonna have to be very careful how we treat that space because we don't want these big, ugly registers all over the place.
Yeah, I think the design plan for the dining room, I always envision when you walk into the house, this is what you're seeing. And so I really want to use a contrast of color here. So I'm imagining we can use some wall covering here, something darker, something a little bit more sexy for this room for entertaining. And I know the floors in this room are beautiful. They're original parquet. So I'd really love to strip the stain that's on them now and see what that true color is, because I think that could be really beautiful.
Yeah, love it. The butler's pantry, as it stands now, obviously needs a lot of space. The ceilings are dropped. It was an infilled porch at one point. And really had some great detail in the ceiling that has been covered up. The butler's pantry is a great opportunity to take advantage of some of this wall space for some cabinetry.
Yeah, from the design standpoint, I really envision it the same way. I think we have a lot of wall space here, so the whole thing can be integrated millwork. And I think we should use, again, a contrast of color in here. I would even really love to lacquer the walls because I think that would just be a beautiful transition from the kitchen into the great room.
With architectural and design plans in place for the dining room, we can finally start the long-awaited renovation process. But before we begin, it's important to stop and reflect on the past so we can learn how to truly move forward and progress.
So this would have been the primary entertaining space in this house when it was built. And so a lot of the detail is going to be the finest detail in the house as we look around the room. So we have some original Federal 1805 woodwork and details, but then we also have a number of Victorian details. Let's point out a few of those. So without a question, the thing that just carries this room is this mantelpiece. So this is going to be really original to about 1805. So this is a great piece of Federal period woodwork. And it's fantastic when you see a lot of this detail. This is gouge work and fret work. But as you can see, there are probably about 30 layers of paint over it, so it's been obscured. But what's really cool here is you can see this, what looks like an English country scene with a church steeple. And it looks like hounds perhaps chasing a fox. And this will be restored and it'll be spectacular. But when these houses are built, they have huge fireplaces and they're very inefficient. So over the Victorian and 20th century, the fireboxes get smaller and smaller. So what you can see here is the original fireplace that's been filled in for a more efficient burning fireplace, probably when the house was renovated in the 1890s in the Victorian period. The other detail I'd draw your attention to in here is you look at the floor. So this is a parquet floor, and we often think of parquet floors as being very historic. Well, not in Charleston. This is a much later floor. So this is really about 1890s, and as you walk through the rest of the house, we'll see what original floors look like. So a couple of other key details when we look at the Federal woodwork. In addition to the mantel, you have this great trim around the windows and doors. But if you look up at the cornice work, really spectacular fretwork and gouge work. This all would have been carved by hand. It's just remarkable, high quality woodwork, and it's so fantastic that it's still here. But some of the later changes, probably 20th century, or if not in the late Victorian period, you would have had the windows swapped out. These probably would have been 9/9 or 6/6 windows, not these single 1/1s that you see currently. But again, when you look in the jambs, you can see that great original woodwork. So we're right behind the dining room now, but it's interesting if you look here, this is a great Federal transom over this old door. So actually we'd be standing outside of the house, and if you look up above us, you can actually see a Victorian period, but it's a porch ceiling nonetheless. And so here you can see the exterior walls where there were original doors and windows before it was renovated into office spaces.
While the construction team was busy working away, John and Betsy headed to Furnitureland South to choose pieces for the dining room.
This is what you would see in that dining room.
But you're not wanting to go that traditional.
No, I feel like if we chose this and did a really simple upholstered chair and kept the chair really simple, then we could use something like this.
Okay.
The dining room rug is a formal dining room in a really old, beautiful house. So we really need to stay within a traditional vein.
We can always come back with help.
Maybe. Would these be custom? I like the cord. The scale is good. I like the simplicity. I like how the back is inset because you could do a contrast here. Yeah, this. See, I told you, Madagascar rematch. That's what drives me crazy about like American dining chairs, that they feel like they have to be huge. Yeah, these are great.
Should I go get those wine glasses and fill them up?
Yes, I'm ready for a drink.
Should we take it over to the rug?
No. We don't have time.
Okay.
The design and construction of the pantry and dining room inspired me to go shopping for some local Charleston gems. My good pal Bill at the Charleston Tea Garden was kind enough to share some local history with me.
Hey, Bill.
Hey, Darius, how are you?
Great to see you, man.
Welcome to the Charleston Tea Garden.
I'm excited to be here, man.
Thanks for coming out and visiting us.
Oh, thank you for having me, man. I can't wait.
I understand you're a big tea drinker.
I am, and I got this new house I'm building, and I need to fill my pantry with some good tea. So
well, we can fill your pantry. There's no question about that.
So, what part of the plant is the actual tea?
The tea that we use is just the top few leaves off the top of the plant. And we harvest from May till the end of October.
Okay.
So you get about 9 harvests a year. There's only 3 basic teas in the world. There's black tea, green tea, and oolong tea. Everything is an offshoot of those.
Okay.
Like Earl Grey. Earl Grey is black tea that's had oil of bergamot sprayed on it.
Okay.
Jasmine tea, green tea with jasmine flowers added to it. So you only have those 3 basic teas, and they all come from the same plant. So, Darius, have you tried our tea at all?
I actually have. I had it at the Rutledge house.
Oh, really?
It was great. It was iced tea, but I'm looking forward to getting some hot tea in there.
Okay, so this is our hot tea side.
Which one's the black tea?
With no flavoring is the Charleston breakfast.
Okay.
Careful, it's hot now. Too strong?
No, it tastes great. Not too strong at all.
Oh, okay, so you like strong.
Well, I like my tea strong. I do.
Yeah. Okay.
I mean, I drink tons of it because of, you know, getting warmed up for shows and then right after the show and, you know, in the morning for my throat. So yeah, I love it strong.
Now you want to try some iced tea?
Oh, I love iced tea. Yes, I do.
You do as well. Okay, good.
Yes.
This is our cold tea side. And the first one is peach.
Oh man, that's so good.
Is that all right?
That's so good.
That's our raspberry tea.
Man, that's some good tea. Like your flavors are not too overwhelming,
right.
And I love that.
Yeah.
I love it. Let's try the original. Oh, that's definitely my favorite.
And that's unsweetened. I don't know if you want.
That doesn't. I'm from Charleston. I don't even know what that is.
It doesn't exist.
You know, coming to Charleston Tea Garden was amazing. I love the history of this city so much, and to know that tea making in America began right here, and now to know that the only tea farm in the United States is right here, the Charleston Tea Garden. We're trying to find stuff, especially local stuff, to stuff the pantry with. And I'm such a tea drinker. And first of all, it's great tea, but it's also great that it's coming from the same place I came from. And that's pretty awesome.
Man,
and when you run out, you let me know, okay?
I will, man. God bless you.
All right.
Thank you, Bill.
Thanks very much.
All right, in the pantry, we still have a couple of issues in the pantry. Namely, are we going to get our refrigerators in? That is backed up.
Okay.
But we've picked out all the cabinetry is actually being made right now. So that will be installed. We were like 30 days out. If you remember behind you, the same slab that we picked out goes right here. And this is your coffee maker.
Okay.
In the morning. Your cooler sink is right here. So I know how many dishes you do.
Yeah, right? Really
I know
big
you do
at
all
that.
The dishes.
Yeah, really
but whoever, it's that. Nice if you look, you know, you're gonna be able to sink is center nicely and you've got that nice view of the
yard.
Oh,
cool, yeah.
And then you've got dishwashers right under here. But everything in here outside the refrigerators, I think we're gonna be good to go. And next month I think this thing's gonna be popping.
Awesome.
Well, in the dining room here, I love this dining room table you picked out.
Yeah, that's a good choice. You know, it went cheap on the dining room.
Very utilitarian. We can move that around.
Yeah.
This is not a lot to do with this room. The real tricks were how we ended up handling AC.
Yeah.
We didn't want to mess with anything historical. If you look how we handled the intake, this was a real trick. And our mechanical engineers did a great job. So we have an intake right here. And then we've got your registers that are coming out here.
Cool.
And they are, we did a lot of work. It's all under the house. So I know it's a little messy. That's just dust. And we will clean and then we'll protect them. We'll put a protectant over them. But this is how, you know, this is how it'll be.
I mean, it looks great. And you look at this room's probably the most along of all the rooms, you know? And I mean, you know, a room like this is so important just because of the entertainment. Amen. You know, the people we're going to have here eating dinner, the people I'm going to have over here just hanging out, this will be a lot of the center of it. So, you know, I'm glad it's coming along. I'm glad, you know, it's going to be absolutely exactly what I want. Beautiful.
Yeah. And you have church bells at dinner.
I love the church bells.
So, no, it's awesome. You just have a little seat for me over here.
One seat.
One seat.
Small. At the kids' table.
Dining room was all about hosting family and friends. As it nears completion, I'm inspired to go have dinner with some old buddies.
Hey, gentlemen, for the entree course this evening, we have a selection of some favorites. So on this side here, we have our shrimp and grits. We've got some awesome local wreck fish there. It's coming on a sweet potato puree with some crispy cauliflower and a butternut squash caponata on top. We also have our pork chop, and on the far side there, you have our barbecue tuna, definitely the most unique dish on the menu, but such an awesome combination of flavors.
Thank you.
Awesome. Family style, boys?
Family style.
These fried oysters, boys.
Yeah, on top of the
tuna.
Oh my God. Crazy.
That rack fish is so good.
They're really good.
This is a great meal. Everything.
The thing about Charleston restaurants is it's very easy to get local stuff because there's so much of it around. I mean, it's farms and there's the sea and there's the mountains are close and all. And that's one of the things. But, you know, going back 30 years, 35 years, guys came and they made a name for themselves. And you remember because you've been here forever.
Yeah.
But, you know, amazing places.
Yeah.
You
said something earlier that I've said to people a lot. I know we don't have the number of restaurants in New York, but I think we rival New York in definitely in quality. And if you're not a great restaurant, you don't last in Charleston.
So true.
I mean, all these chefs that are around here, they're all friends.
Yeah.
And they're all, and I love that. You know, when I play golf with those guys, it's great to, you know, it's great to be out there with them because you realize they work in what most people consider rival restaurants, but they're really good friends. Just having
they really have a lot of common.
Yes, and they're pulling for each other.
Yeah,
they know in a town like this they can all be successful.
And there's no shortage of people coming in. That's
and that's not going to change.
No, and a lot of people complain about it, but you know what? There's always room for greatness.
Man, that was a great meal. That was a great meal. I mean, eating here like this and being across from my place, this is like, I can't wait to have our group of friends sitting around a big table in my place eating like this, you know?
I know how much this room means to Darius. The dining room for entertaining, to have his family over, it's really just the center of a Southern home. So I'm a little bit nervous to show him the room because we have some strong accents in here, but I'm also really excited for him to see it. Here we are in your dining room. I never had a silver spoon. I didn't grow up in a castle. I'll never walk on the moon. I love this room.
Me too.
This room was one of my first kind of visions and ideas. It always was the dining room of the home, right? Right on the street. And so I know this color is dark and, you know, it could be a little bit too much, but I loved
the risk of
doing it. The light fixture, same thing. It's a big moment. It's just a complete showpiece.
That's the word. It's just perfect hanging over this table too.
And then we're balancing it in the room. You know, we have the original molding. We have this original mantle, which is really large in scale. It's gorgeous.
Yeah, it is beautiful.
This is actually wall covering and it's pieced together. It's called tobacco paper because way back in the day when wallpaper was first being made, they didn't have the giant mills to run it through, so it was literally put together in pieces, and that's why you have these seams throughout the room, which ties back to the age of the home.
The thing that you've done so well is you got the oldness of everything, and you walk in this room and this mantle just takes your breath away, and you look at everything, but then you look at this is so modern and the table's so modern, but it all fits in together. And I'm so glad we found these floors and kept them.
Yes.
The floors are so perfect for him.
The floors, this is the original parquet. We actually took off a layer of stain, which shows it's more of a contrast. And it's just, I mean, you don't have to do anything. They're gorgeous. I never had a silver spoon. I didn't grow up in a castle. Never walked on the moon. I never played a Sistine Chapel. So here we are, the butler's pantry. So we uncovered the ceiling and we restored it, and now with the high gloss it just turned out really beautiful. We have a lot of things in this room. So you have your sink, obviously looking out over the yard with the Kohler faucet. We have refrigerator drawers, dishwasher, and your coffee set up here, set into solid slab. Again, amazing.
Yeah.
Great way to get your coffee in the morning.
Absolutely.
Obviously, we then have a ton of storage. And then it's really for entertaining as well.
Yeah.
In the living room.
Yeah, this is awesome. Man, this is beautiful. We'll be right back.
It's just, I mean, it just so, seems so perfect together. The way you brought the floor and the mantle and the artwork, beautiful. I'm ready for Thanksgiving with the family.
Yeah.
I,
yeah.
I remember walking into the dining room when we first got it, and you know, it just feels, it feels what just exactly like what I wanted the house to feel like. The history, you could see it, you could feel it. But when you sit down, the modern touches brings it all back to today. Seriously, can't wait to have Thanksgiving there with my family. I can't wait to, you know, have some, you know, my whole family, my sisters and brothers and their kids, and our cousins and all, have them over just to sit at that table and, you know, just eat and be family. And that, I mean, that's what that room made me feel like.